all heard of blood transfusion, blood donation camps. So, have you all received got cake in SS birthday? So, if you have not received cake, at least some of you might have gone for blood donation. How many of you have donated blood? Okay, very good numbers. So, can we consider this blood as a thrombolytic agent or a therapeutic agent? Yes. How many of you are having the answer yes for this question? Is blood a therapeutic agent? Can blood be used as an agent which cures or heals the patient?
Yes.
Okay. So, can it be considered as an agent of pharmaceutical importance? Is blood produced in the labs? Okay. So, can we call it as drug or not a drug? Not a drug? All of you? Anyone? Yes, it is a drug. Okay. So, that's why we need to understand the basic concept of what is drug. Okay, so let me tell you. Call behind you. Last venture. Yes. You want to attend the class? Yes. You need to be listening to me, not with you. What are you having in your hand? Okay. Yes. The definition of drug is, drug is a substance or an agent which is used or intended to be used. Okay, so that means a positive approach is necessary for the patient. Not that you give the drug, the patient is cured. It never happens. At least in 20 to 40% of the patient, it never happens that you have cured the patient. But the intention with which you are given is very important. That's why a drug is an agent or a substance which is used or intended to be used to modify or to explore the physiological or pathological status for the benefit of the recipient. So, understand, by going word to word with this definition, can blood be included here? Yes, blood is an agent which is used for the benefit of the recipient. Okay, so drug is a very broad term which includes everything, including the IV fluids which we have administered, or a therapeutic agent, or just a radio contrast media which you might have administered. Okay, everything comes under drug. Okay, so understanding the basics, we'll now turn over to the hematinics. Okay, hematinics means blood and the allied agents or blood-like products which can be used for the patients for their benefit. Okay. Hematinics. Today we will be dealing with what are the basic components, what are the conditions where we can use this blood, and what do you call the condition where we have deficiency of this blood? Anemia. Okay. So, how many liters of blood we have?
Five.
So, last class, everyone was away. So, we discussed that in last class. Anemia. What is this anemia? Anemia can be due to the mismatch between the production and the destruction, or production and the loss which is happening there. Okay. So, this is a condition in which the balance is not maintained. Okay. So, it may be due to the blood loss. Suddenly you are rushing to the class or going out to the class. You may have an injury, there may be blood loss. Impaired red cell formation. So there are so many conditions where hereditary conditions are there, where the blood production is not optimum, or bone marrow disease. So many bone marrow conditions are there. Okay, so there may be innumerable such conditions. increased destruction of RBCs. Yes, this can also be a problem where the spleen may be enlarged. Okay, so the meshwork along across which the blood has to transfer in the spleen, there will be problem. So there will be more and more destruction, or the blood cells actually are of higher size, which has to be the normal size. That means like a normal size may be around 7 microns and your blood cells are 12 microns. It occurs in immature, when immature RBCs are circulating. So there will be increased destruction of RBCs. So there are so many conditions where you get destruction of RBCs. Okay, maybe you have given some transfusion and these blood cells belong to some other group. What will happen? Autoimmune response will be there. Blood destructions will be there. So there will be so many conditions where you get the destructions. Okay, so hematogenics, they are also called as anti-anemic agents. Okay, so your question paper may also have the title describe about anti-anemic. So the answer should be one and the same. And we need to understand what are the other precursors of our RBCs. Is it the only iron which is required or any other agents? Okay, so there is also other agents, very important agents which are required for the maturation of RBCs, that is B1 and folic acid. Okay. So most of the time we'll be supplementing iron in case of anemia. It is not so that because iron only may not be sufficient, because you need to understand which type of anemia we are having, whether it is the impaired production or more of destruction. Okay, so you get a typical picture called as microcytic hypochromic anemia. Microcytic means the RBCs here are smaller. Hypochromic means the color of the RBCs is not that red. Okay, so in this case it is microcytic hypochromic means it is iron deficiency anemia, okay, or thalassemia. In these two cases you will get, there are few other conditions where you get microcytic hypochromic anemias. Okay, so if it is megaloblastic anemia, there is problem with maturation factors, that is folic acid or B12 deficiencies. Okay, so thinking that the most common condition is iron deficiency anemia, we'll proceed with our topic. Okay, so iron, what is the total iron? So 5 liters of iron is there, 5 liters of blood is there, that means 5 liters of blood, 5 kgs. So approximately 1 kg of iron is there? No, it is just 5 grams. Okay, so you can see here the iron content is just 2 to 5 grams. Okay, so hemoglobin, how it is distributed? Hemoglobin is about 66%. Then we have myoglobin and iron stores in the form of ferritin and hemoglobin, then parenchymal iron. So including all that, it becomes 2 to 5 grams. What is this hemoglobin? Now coming to the particular part of the RBC where the iron is formed. Okay, so the iron is formed in the heme part of this hemoglobin. Okay, so what is this hemoglobin? It is a protophosphorylated having 4 iron containing heme residues. That means heme does not exist as a single molecule, it is a complex of 4 molecules. What is the daily requirement here? About 10 milligram. Okay, so approximately the absorption will be 10% of what we consume. So if we are consuming 10 gram, 10 milligrams, you will be getting 1 milligram. Okay, so 1/10 of what you consume will be incorporated there if the system is working normally. Okay. It's okay. You can see. Yes. So adult male is about 1 gram, female is double, pregnancy about 3 to 4 times. So this is the normal daily requirement. Then what are the factors which will help our iron absorption? Okay. So lot of people are now concentrating on iron medicines. So you need to take care or ask the question whether your grandmother or mother-in-law has prescribed you some medicines, iron medicines, because the common people people who will be coming for us with anemia are the pregnant ladies. Okay, pregnant ladies or the pre-pregnant in that age group, like 20 to 30 years. Those are the people. So you need to take care that whether she is on any Ayurvedic medications which contains phosphate and phytates. Most of these Ayurvedic medications are plant derivatives. What are plants basically made up of? Phosphates and phytates. Okay, so if they are on this, we need to avoid this. Alkalis, whether the person is taking already on antacids. Once the mother's womb is there, what will happen? There is decreased space for the stomach. It will be pushed up. What will happen? GI irritation will be there. So she may be taking some bicarbonates, alkalis, whether she is taking some antacid syrups. Okay, tetracyclines. So less commonly used drugs, you know. Previously, these are the most common drugs which were used for the common cold and all. So we need to avoid those drugs when we are telling the patient to take iron supplements. So what are the factors which will help? Okay, the non-vegetarian diet basically. Okay, so the acid. Okay, so when does the acid get secreted more? When you are taking the red meat. Okay, red meat or wine or the conditions which will increase the stomach GI acidity. Okay, ascorbic acid, that means vitamin C. Okay, so you are taking when the patient is on some secret food, lemon juice or musubi juice like that. That may help amino acid diet. Okay, so that means again indirectly a non-vegetarian diet or meat. Okay, all these factors are facilitating the iron absorption. Then we have some concept for the aspartame cutting. Actually, this is for the MCQ questions for the medicines. Okay, you can also get this. What is this aspartame cutting? It's a mechanism where the iron gets stored in the GI mucosal cells and get shed out when it is not required, or when there is optimal level of iron in the plasma, this will not be recirculated and this will be shed off as the body cells get destroyed after their lifetime. Okay. So that is aspartame cutting. It remains in the mucosal cells and lost when it is optimum. Coming to the iron transport absorption or this. Okay, so once you have taken the iron containing food or the iron containing tablet, what will happen? It should be converted to ferrous form. Okay, so ferric form is the one. Ferric means Fe3+, ferrous means Fe2+. Just remember ferric and ferrous. So in order to cross across the membranes, it should be ferric form. Okay, and ferrous form will not be transferred. So once it is inside the cell, we need to convert it or trap it by converting it to ferrous form. So for that, to transfer this ferric form to inside the cell, we have a metal transporter called as DMP1. It is not there. Okay, so out of the interest I am telling, just decrease the number of slides, but some points I will be telling. We need a dimethyl transporter or DMP2 to transport across this iron through the membranes. So iron is transported in the blood in combination with the glycoprotein transferrin. Okay, so and stored. And iron stored in the RE cells. RE cells mean reticuloendothelial cells. These are the precursors also. Okay, these are the precursors for the RBCs. Reticuloendothelial cells, and they are there in the liver stream and bone common in the bone marrow. And in bone marrow, we also have macrophages. Okay, these macrophages also store the iron in the form of hemosiderin. Okay, hemosiderin. Iron is tenaciously conserved. Excretion is approximately about 0.5 to 1 milligram. I told how by mucosal shed. And women, we have this monthly menstrual cycle, and also the exfoliation is present. Both the mechanisms are present for iron excretion. Okay, so here is the diagram. So it will help you to fetch marks if you are given the main question. Okay, how you need to see here. Okay, so you can see the arrows here. Okay, the first part, the food iron. Okay, that is what you can see is Fe3+, that is in ferric form. Now we have converted to the help of this vitamin C or any other agent with to ferrous form, that is Fe2+, where it can be transported across the mucosal layers, and from there we if the iron is excess, we add apoferritin. Okay, iron is combined with apoferritin to form a transferrin. Remember, apoferritin is a transport protein which binds with this iron. Okay, three ferrous form of iron. Okay, this ferrous form along with apoferritin will become ferritin, and it can, this ferritin can be converted to transferrin. Okay, so the basic molecule what we find in the mucosal cell is ferritin. Okay, ferritin is, ferritin contains ferrous form of iron plus apoferritin. Apoferritin is a protein molecule. Okay, the apoferritin plus ferrous iron. Okay, so remember that is the ferritin which is stored there, and if you want to transfer it across, or when there is a requirement, it will be put upon transferrin. Okay, and thereby it gets transported. Okay, once it is need to be transported, we need to convert it back to 3+. Okay, 3+ is the mobile form. Okay, and how do we convert it? With the help of ferrooxidase and ferroreductase. Okay, ferrooxidase and ferroreductase enzymes are the ones which are acting here. Okay, oxidation means addition of oxygen or removal of electron. Okay, oxidation means addition of electron, addition of oxygen or removal of electron. Okay, so here what we are doing, removal of electron. Okay, that is 3+ to 2+. That means we are dealing with ferrooxidase enzyme. So there is a transferrin receptor there where it will be again brought into the needed cell. Okay, where the iron is needed. Okay, from there, that is the third procedure, receptor mediated endocytosis will be there. Then there will be free pool iron. Here it is 3+. That means it can be converted to, here it is the apoferritin form. Okay, and there will be autophagocytosis. Okay, autophagocytosis, that means macrophage can phagocytize the excess iron content in the body and store in the bone marrow, liver, spleen. Okay, so this is how it takes place. Transfer. Just try to practice this diagram. You can be helpful for your exams. Okay. So once it is stored there, and bone marrow is the site where the blood synthesis will occur. Okay. So there only it can be utilized from the macrophages, and also liver and spleen act as a blood synthesis center. Can the blood be synthesized in the liver and spleen? Yes. Okay. In infants below 1 year of age, the blood synthesis actually occurs in liver and spleen. Okay. So these are also the centers where blood synthesis will occur. Okay. So with that completes the absorption, distribution, and excretion. Excretion part we discussed initially. Okay. Coming to the iron preparations. What are the preparations of iron which we are going to give? Okay, the most common preparation is the oral ferrous sulfate. Okay, the most common preparation which is available from the government supply is ferrous sulfate. Now, people are not commonly using this because of the GI acidity which it can produce, and most of the other commercial preparations which are available from the medical shop, they contain ferrous aspartate and ferrous. Okay, ferrous aspartate, actually it is not there here. Okay, why it is not there is because according to the chronological order, the iron content is displayed here. Okay, almost this ferrous sulfate contains more. Ferrous fumarate is second foremost efficient agent. Okay, but the commonly used agent present is ferrous aspartate, which has lesser iron content and lesser GI upset. Okay, that's why the patients have discontinued the use of iron because of this acidity. And Prabhendridi, we already discussed that GI acidity is more. Why? Because the stomach is pushed up. Okay, that's one more problem. That's why we are now commonly using the fifth agent, that is ferrous aspartate. And according to the therapy purpose, which is the best agent, ferrous sulfate and ferrous fumarate. Okay. The parenteral iron, that means if it is causing J acidity, why can't we go for the parenteral route? Okay, the parenteral route are intravenous and intramuscular. Okay, so intramuscular iron injections are very painful injections because it is a very thick preparation and it will be very painful and the staining will be there. Okay, wherever you give injection, there will be a black dot. Because it is so thick, it can come back up in the same track. And the technique what we use here is called as Z-track technique. That means we just pinch and pull the skin and just then inject. Okay, so once we pull the skin, what happens? The injected site is here and the track site is here. So iron injection may not actually come out and we may not have space to come out. That's why we use the Z-track technique. That means you are pinching and pulling the skin and putting it back, and once you remove the pinched skin, the skin which is retracting is somewhere here. Okay, so it may not trace the tract in which the injection was inserted. That's why we go for Z-track technique. Otherwise, if we are cumbersome, we can go for straight. Only thing is there will be black pigmentation there. Okay, never mind if the patient is of darker color. Because with the idea of doing this Z-track technique, you may actually not insert the injection properly. Okay. Have you done injections? No normal injections. You should learn as a doctor, you should learn to give intramuscular injection. Okay, whenever you have time, just go to the government hospital injection room where the sisters will be fed up of giving injections and learn it. Okay. Because it's a life saving. Okay, adrenaline, how will you give in anaphylaxis? Intramuscular injection. So as a doctor, you may be called upon by some of your friends. Okay, you are a doctor, just put me this injection. Okay, you can't tell, I am a dentist, I don't know how to do this. Okay, that should not be your answer. So where do we need this iron preparations? Isn't that only the iron deficiency anemia? We also have some other uses. The first and the foremost important thing is iron deficiency anemia. And we need to remember that when you are supplementing the iron, you should also supplement the other products which are needed for the synthesis of hemoglobin. What are the other products? B12 and folic acid. Okay, so it should be supplemented there. And where is we can get, we told the blood loss, we told the destruction, and destruction is also more common when we have this disease. What is this?
Malaria.
Okay, malaria, what will happen? The precursor RBCs will be more. We have a specific type of malaria diseases where they just go and multiply inside the RBCs only. And what happens to the size of the RBC now? It will be increased. Okay, there more of the precursor RBCs will be there. So these precursor RBCs and the plasmodium vivax malaria causing parasite containing RBCs, they will be filtered in the spleen and they cannot pass across this spleen filter. There will be destruction there. Okay, so these are the conditions where we need to go for iron deficiency anemia and the blood transfusion or the blood products. Megaloblastic anemia, yes, megaloblastic anemia, though it is due to the B12 deficiency, but body may not have the iron stores once you are supplemented with B12. Are you getting the idea? As there was no enough B12 there in the body might not also have stored the iron required for the production. Okay, once you supplement with B12 in megaloblastic anemia, there will be sudden spurt of hemopoiesis. Okay, sudden spurt of hemopoiesis, you may need to supplement iron also. Okay, so the better way of treating is to give B12, folic acid and also iron. Okay, perichloride can also be used as a roadway, that is the iron preparation way. What adverse effects? We have discussed part of it, the gastric pain, nausea, diarrhea, all these symptoms can be seen with oral preparations, and local injections we told pigmentation of the skin, abscess. Abscess formation is more common with intramuscular injection and more so with the iron injections, because it's a painful, the patient may slip off. We need to stabilize the patient and tell the patient it's a painful, you should not be mobile, otherwise the injection may go over some other crack. Okay, so the best type of injection what we give will be complete needle insertion. Sometimes out of hesitation or frightenedness, the sister or the trainee sister may not insert the needle completely. There also there is formation of abscess. Why abscess? Because you might have inserted the injection in the subcutaneous tissue. Okay, so the needle should actually enter the muscle layer. Okay, there this absorption will be better. If it is there somewhere in the subcutaneous tissue, there will be abscess formation. Okay, so systemic other things, when we are given parenchymal iron, there can be fever, joint pains, flushing, palpitations, wave birth, iron infusions can also cause the adverse drug reactions and they are dreaded. Okay, sudden iron infusions are very dangerous. Duct of the iron dextran, iron sorbitol citrate, all these are very dangerous preparations. Why dangerous? Because they are more toxic. Okay, iron excess can lead to poisoning. Okay, so the next slide we will learn about the iron poisoning. And the negative point with this preparation is the metallic taste. Okay, so metallic taste you might have noticed when you have taken the C-block TZ orange color tablet when you have gastroenteritis. Anyone has tried it? No one. Okay, so that metallic taste will be there with iron preparations also. Anaphylaxis or anaphylactoid reaction, that means anaphylaxis like reactions can be seen. Okay, these are the dangers and you should be prepared and be ready for the adverse reactions. So what if we have not noticed that and it has landed up in acute iron poisoning? Okay, so the patient will have excessive sweating, breathlessness, falling of blood pressure, all these things will be there. And what are the organs there? And iron can be deposited in the heart, liver, pancreas. All these manifestations in the form of vomiting, abdominal pain, hematemesis, all these things. Okay, so treatment is to the help of iron chelating agent, that is desferoxamine. Okay, desferoxamine is the iron chelating agent which we use. And giving egg yolk and milk along with the dose what they have taken. Suppose the patient may be having the problem of depression and thinking that I want to die, they may take 10 iron tablets. Okay, then also it can lead land up in iron poisoning and there we can start with the stomach wash. Okay. All this is possible and there if you can keep milk orally, you can decrease the iron absorption. So, coming to the megaloblastic anemia. So for medical students, that will be the last slide for class. Here I need to hurry up because I have only 6 classes to cover the entire blood. Okay, so megaloblastic anemia, these are known as the maturation agents. Deficiency of these maturation agents will lead to megaloblastic anemia. That means our peripheral smear showing increased or bigger sized RBCs. Okay. Why there is bigger size RBCs when maturity is not there? Normally we assume that whenever the baby is small, it is small and any mature thing should be bigger. It is vice versa with our RBCs. The precursors are bigger, the actual RBCs are smaller. Why? RBCs does not contain nucleus. Okay, only during the maturation phase they contain nucleus. They are enucleated cells. Okay, RBCs are enucleated cells. Yes, remove this hand. Remove. Second benches. Remove those hands. You will get sleepy. So better.